morning, everybody. I'm Sandy Diamond. You're now doing the videotaping, my beautiful grandmother, and we're going to go get to the horse that I call the Big Red Mare. My feeling about going to a horse, whether it's in a field, a paddock, a stall, whatever, tie stalls, not quite the same, but that's a different thing. Most people don't use tie stalls anymore. Anyway, I don't walk straight into a horse and expect them to tolerate that. So Luna's going to see how things go here. As I keep telling people in my video, an 8-year-old had essentially 6 weeks of training by a professional trainer, had never been cantered under saddle. In a very unfortunate circumstance during the training, and was in side reins and got tooth and slipped over backwards, and the owner brought us home. The owner being a stable doctor, a stable tactic, you might want to stand so exposure to him and I'm trying to keep my baby. Anyway, so the mare was in a lot of trouble. So you notice I stood up there and I waited for her to catch me. I came for a couple of years, maybe 3 years, before April and I came up with the scheme that I should be able to help her with her course. And one of the times I was here, time before last, before I moved over, we had worked with the horse 3 days in a row. I was going to take the ferry back to the mainland, because this was Vancouver Island. And I said, why don't we just go and get that mare of yours and play with her for a little bit before I take the ferry? Well, you know, 3 hours later, and it was a pretty good sized clinic. We had, I don't know, 5 or 6 people here, plus April and her husband. I think her husband was involved. And everybody was involved, and all I did was go stand in the middle of the field that's back there, and everybody else just, as soon as she came anywhere near them, they all had tricks, and they just chased her away until she finally found me. But it was genuinely 3 hours. So, here's the thing. So, I always go into this snare this way. And the reason that I do that, you see how she turns her head to block me from walking in there? If it wasn't for the fact that I already had a lot of time with this mare, and I don't mean, you know, an hour a day for, you know, 6 months. I mean, we're talking 3 or 4 hours a day for the last year, plus the clinic that I was here. So she just came off a few 3 months vacation. She's been getting, what, Luna, 3, 4 times maybe?
In the whole 3 months.
In the whole 3 months, something like that. Now you notice, when she opened her head up to let me come in, I didn't just grab in there, but I gave her a moment to think about that now, and then the throat will feel better. This, man, this is golden. This is, you know, when Luna and I were working her last summer, well, we started, Luna figured she started middle of May last year, 2019, and I'm going to talk a little bit about Luna here. Because Luna had been in a 7-year program with a local breeder, dressage type, and she knew how to put a horse on the vet. She knew how to put the leg on. She knew how to use her feet. But this horse couldn't take that. So Luna came the first time to ride the horse, and she saw got on the horse, she put her feet in the saddle, put the leg on, took a hold of the horse, and I watched the horse, and I said, Luna, hold on a second, go to the buckle end of the ring. And Luna said, well, I don't do that. No, don't really kick. So that's where Luna and I started. And when Luna would lead a horse, it was like this. And if the horse was going to go through a little space, Luna'd stand in that space because she's going to block the horse from coming through that space. I think Luna weighs about 130 pounds. It's not a good thing to do. So anyhow, I'm going to ask this horse to come out of its man gate, and I'm going to do it one of the ways that I really like doing it. It's only one of the few. So Luna, if you just back up a little bit over there, what I'm going to do, Luna, I'm just going to ask you to yield the right hip. And yesterday, Luna, when you rode her, was it the right hip she was sticking at you?
Left hip.
Left hip. Okay. All right. That's cool. Then I'll work with the yielding the left hip. But in order to do that, I have to move her over here. And then, around a little bit. I'm just going to step over here. How do you know about that step? Have the shoulder stay here. Bring your head a little bit. Bring your head a little bit. I'm just going to ask you to step my foot just a little. There we go. So she's lined up there. There. Now I can just feel their front end away, get her off the back gate. I'll ask her to back up, right, left, drop that rope down so she knows. I don't have to point out her or push on her or pull on her or any of that. Just going to take the rope up. This mare used to be pretty volatile.